So that's another big thing for setting yourself up for success is grow what you enjoy. Good morning, Modern Steaders. This morning, I thought we'd talk about how to homestead with a full-time job and succeed at it. We get questions all the time about this topic. Hey Al, how are you doing it? You got a full-time job, you got a YouTube channel, and you raise your own animals, you homestead. So I thought today we'd start a topic on it. Today I'm gonna go over our general way of how we homestead with a full-time job. And if you guys want, leave it in the comments down below and we can dig deeper on each topic, or we can leave it as a bigger overview. But let me know what you want to do and let's talk about how we homestead and succeed at it with a full-time job. One of the things I really like to do that takes a lot of stress off of us is I go, okay, the animals gotta have plenty of water and they gotta have plenty of feed. An animal wants to eat at least twice a day, and they gotta have constant water in front of them. If we're not home, if we need to take off for a weekend, if something happens, how can we do this and feel comfortable that it's gonna work? So for our pigs, you can see they're eating out of their automatic feeder. That'll hold almost 3 bags of feed, so that'll last a long time for a pig. I'm gonna show you over here their waterer. Right now with our climate, we can't use our automatic waters because they'll be freezing, but I have a 55-gallon drum here with a water nippler on it. I can fill our 55-gallon drum up and that'll last at least a week for the pigs, if not 2 or 3, depending on the time of the year and how hot it is. So that way we know our pigs are always gonna have constant water in front of them. If for some reason we're not around, we have to take off for a weekend, they're good to go. Over here we have our mobile chicken coop that we call New York City, that I have set up with rain gutters. In the summer, spring, and winter, I have it set up with a 55-gallon drum. Excuse me, the rooster's being kind of noisy. But if it wasn't for the noisy roosters, it wouldn't be authentic. In our 3 seasons that we can, we have our automatic waterer set up on our mobile chicken coop. That way they have a constant supply of water and we don't have to worry about that. It's kind of hard to believe it, but right here behind me is our garden. It's crazy, but one of the things we do when we're gardening is we use deep mulch. What this does, it suppresses the weeds. That's less time we gotta be in our garden weeding, and it keeps the moisture in our garden. So less time we have to be watering our garden, and all of that makes for a better garden and produces more produce for us. So that's a great time saver right there. Is basically we plant our vegetable seeds, we let them grow, we take a lot of care and tend to them when they're smaller. Once they get bigger, keep an eye on them. We don't have to do much work. We come out, we pick some fruit and vegetables off of them when it's time, and it just works amazingly. We get to reap all the benefits with not a lot of hard work involved. Our outdoor kitchen's gonna save us a lot of time and help us homestead. It can take a lot of stuff off of our plate. Last year we spent a lot of time building the outdoor kitchen, but now that we have it, it's gonna make our workflow so much easier and so much quicker. Now we'll have a place to come in, we can wash all of our produce, we can put it out on tables, work on it, we can be cooking in here in the summertime with our flat top grill. One of the huge advantages of having the outdoor kitchen is gonna be in the summertime when it's hot and humid out and we don't wanna cook inside and heat up our house, we'll be doing that out here. When it's time to can, we're not gonna be wanting canning in the house and having all that heat. So now we have a place to do it. We have a place to keep all of the mess. When we get our produce, we can bring it out here, we can wash it. We don't gotta have that in the house. So it's gonna be a huge time saver and a huge advantage for us. We're gonna have a nice place just to sit down and relax and enjoy our homestead. All of our chicken tractors we have equipped with automatic waters. This one holds 5 gallons and we'll keep about 25 birds in here. So that 5 gallons of water will last them a few days. We just want to make sure we know when we're going to work that our animals are taken care of and we don't have to worry about coming home that it was say 100 degrees out and they ran out of water and then some of the animals didn't make it. That's not a good thing. So we want to make sure we have plenty of water for our animals all the time. Now for our Joel Salatin style chicken tractor, the one we can build for 30 bucks in right around 30 minutes. We have our bucket waterer. We can set this right in the corner on one of the platforms we built, fill it up with 5 gallons of water, and the chicks can drink right out of it. So So this is a really slick setup also. Let me show you the feeder that we built for that same chicken tractor. This is the chicken feeder we use. This will hold 25 pounds of chicken feed, and we can keep this in the tractor. I'm gonna put a link to that playlist right here showing you how we build the feeder, the waterer, and the chicken tractor. But this just works awesome. We can load this up with food, we can load it up with water, and we know the chickens are good to go for a few days. We can keep an eye on them every day, but this way, hey, if we're busy, because we're all busy, we don't have to be lugging water and food to them a couple of times a day. We can do it once or twice a week and stay on top of it, and it makes life easier for all of us. And believe it or not, it produces a better quality, whether it's a chicken, a pig, or gardens. They're not stressed. They're more relaxed and comfortable. They have plenty of food and water in front of them all the time. So they're just gonna keep on growing the way they're supposed to grow. It's gonna give them nice tender meat. It's gonna grow good vegetables for us because they're not stressed. So if we can do our part and have everything that they need in front of them all the time, we're gonna have better quality food. That's what we're doing this for. We're doing it so we can grow the best quality of food. So if we can set ourselves up to succeed and have all of our systems in place, because we are all busy, whether we're working full-time or we have other things going on, there's always something going on. So we want to make sure we always have what our animals need in front of them without stressing us out. We want this to be easy, because if this isn't, not easy is not the word, but if it's not enjoyable, we're not gonna wanna do it. And this is fun for us. So we wanna make sure we have everything set up so we do succeed. And this is the secrets of how we do it. I don't know how good you can see that over there, but that's a trommel. When we had rabbits, I miss having rabbits. And I don't miss having rabbits for the meat. I miss having rabbits for the manure. We would compost the manure in worm compost beds. And then I had a trommel. Well, here's the trommel, we still have it. We would run the compost through the trommel. We put it in that end. This spins. We have the smaller net. Let's see if I can get you over there. This has a smaller screen, so only the fines come out. This is a little bit bigger of a screen, so you're gonna have the bigger compost coming out, and then out here you're gonna have your worms and your unfinished compost. And in this one you're gonna have medium compost with a lot of worm eggs. This one's just gonna be fines with no worm eggs. And the great thing about that was is the fines we could use in the house, and we didn't have to worry about having worms everywhere. The medium compost with all the worm eggs worked awesome. We could either put that back in to our worm compost bin, or we could take that and put that into our garden, and that would just add that many more earthworms to our garden, which is just amazing. They stop pooing in our garden, they start digging and loosening up the soil. That means less rototilling for us. And then the unfinished compost and the worms, which had their eggs in it too, we'd put that back into the compost bin, let it keep composting. And it worked amazing, and it works amazing. I kind of got off topic there. But the reason we don't have rabbits here is we moved more to a northern climate, and it has an extremely cold and long winter. So we would constantly be switching out their water. We don't have any barns or heated structure here to have rabbits or their water in. So we'd be setting ourselves up for failure where we are right now if we raised rabbits. So we don't have rabbits. I'd love to have rabbits again, especially to be using our trommel. We just had the best compost with it. We had an awesome garden because of it. I mean, I'm dreaming again of rabbits and the rabbit poo. But that's why we don't have them right now, because it wouldn't be good for us or for the animals. We need to pace ourselves, and someday we'll get rabbits again and we'll get that trommel going again. But that's, you need to just keep thinking ahead, like, what do I want? Why do I want to do it? And what's my end goal? And see how can I get there with where you are. Work with what you have. Nobody's situation's perfect. So work with what we have and then build off of that. The other thing is only raise things you enjoy, whether it's you're raising them to eat or if you're raising them for fun. Don't go and raise something or grow something that you don't like, you know, because then you're not going to want to put the time, energy, and effort into it. Because I'm not going to lie, it takes a lot of time, energy, and effort. Even though we have our systems in place, we still have a lot of time involved. But it's fun and we enjoy it, And if I didn't like what I was growing or like what I was doing, I wouldn't want to do it. So that's another big thing for setting yourself up for success is grow what you enjoy eating. And think about why you want to do this. So that way you have in your head, right now I got a cold. I don't want to be outside feeding my animals, but I know why I want to do it. So it helps gets me out of bed in the morning and makes me stay motivated to do it. Because there's going to be some days when you're not going to want to do this. When you're going to have a cold, you're going to be run down, whatever it is, you got to make sure you stay motivated and stay doing it. So if you have your bigger why in front of you, that'll keep you motivated. For us, we do this to grow the best food possible for our family because we know when we're eating other food, we don't feel as well. If we have one or two meals out to eat or just not good food, we feel it, and I definitely feel it. So I know, okay, this is why I'm doing it. I want to be healthy. I want to feel good. So that's my big driver, and that keeps us going and keeps everything in front of us and going, okay, this is worth it. It might not be the easiest thing in the world every day, but it's worth it, and we enjoy doing it, and we love the lifestyle we live. And we want you guys to feel the same way when you're doing this. Set yourself up for success so you love and you enjoy what you're doing when you're doing it. If you're not already subscribed to our channel, now is a great opportunity for you to do that. And while you're down there, ring the bell, turn on notifications. If you want, go into your notification settings and you can click how often you want to get our notifications. Sometimes, always, not very often. Play around with those settings and you'll get more notifications from us. I'm going to put a link here in the description down below. You can sign up for our newsletter and we'll send you newsletters every once in a while. And remember, we upload a video every day at 6 a.m. We'll see you right back here tomorrow at Lumnah Acres, a guide to modern homesteading, self-sufficiency, and freedom. Bye.